We have some breaking news for you. A federal judge dismissed Stormy Daniels' defamation lawsuit against President Trump. As you might recall, Stephanie Clifford, also known as Stormy Daniels, claimed Trump defamed her when he called her allegations that she was threatened to stay quiet about their alleged affair a, quote, total con job. Athena Jones joins us now. Athena, what exactly does this ruling mean?
Hi, Jake. Well, this is certainly a victory for President Trump. That's what his lawyers are calling this. Judge James Otero, the federal judge in California, ruling in his favor, saying that he was exercising his free speech. He was exercising his First Amendment rights, and that his tweet about the skeptical tweet about that story that Stormy Daniels told about being threatened in a Las Vegas parking lot, that was an opinion that is protected and not actionable. Here is more of what Judge Otero said. He wrote, the court agrees with Mr. Trump's argument because the tweet in question constitutes rhetorical hyperbole normally associated with politics and public discourse in the U.S. The First Amendment protects this type of rhetorical statement. So there you go, Judge Otero agreeing with the president's arguments, lawyers' arguments, that he was simply exercising his free speech when he made that tweet. And we're already hearing, of course, from President Trump's legal team, Charles Harder, sending a statement saying that no amount of spin or commentary by Stormy Daniels or by her lawyer can truthfully characterize this as anything but a total victory for President Trump. Jake?
Okay. What are we hearing from Stormy Daniels and her attorney, Michael Avenatti? Are they going to accept this, or are they going to appeal?
Well, you might not be surprised to hear that they are not going to accept this and that they are going to appeal. Michael Avenatti sent out a tweet calling this a limited ruling, stressing that these other actions that Stormy Daniels has going against President Trump are not affected and that they plan to appeal. And sure enough, we saw their notice of appeal. They've already filed it with that court out in California. So this is not over.
This relates to a tweet that the president made that was critical of Stormy Daniels. That she filed a libel suit, a defamation case against him for that. That part of the case has been thrown out. But the part of Stormy Daniels' lawsuit against the president to be free of the agreement, non-disclosure agreement. Thank you. The non-disclosure agreement is still pending. And so there are more legal fights pending between the president and Stormy Daniels. But today relates to defamation, a complete win for the president, including a grant of attorney's fees to the president, which is a particular slap in the face towards Stormy Daniels and
Gloria, he's going to be pretty happy about this, the president.
Well, yeah, because he doesn't have to pay for his attorney fees. Avenatti will have more time to run for president, maybe. But as he says, it's not over because there are still the non-disclosure agreement is still in contention, and she wants to be free of that.
And there's all sorts of other legal battles going on as well.
Right. No, and I do think that the NDA issue may wind up being a bigger issue in some ways for the public at large. But at the end of the day, right, everybody already has an opinion about what happened or didn't happen between President Trump and Stormy Daniels.
And Michael Avenatti really wants to depose President Trump.
Yes.
This doesn't affect the final decision about whether he'll get to depose President Trump, but it certainly doesn't help.
This also doesn't change the fact that had not been for the lawsuit brought by Stormy Daniels, you probably would not have had Michael Cohen go and implicate the president in a federal crime in a court of law.
All right. Breaking news. We're going to stay on top of this.